Pakistan Tehreek Insaf leader Asad Kaiser elected as the Speaker of National Assembly. Kaiser receives 176 votes to be elected to the speakership, whereas Pakistan People's Party's Khurshid Shah gets 146 votes, a total of 330 votes cast, out of which 322 accepted and 8 rejected. Newly elected Speaker administered oath by outgoing Speaker Ayaz Sadiq. Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf leader Qasim Suri elected as the Deputy Speaker of National Assembly. Suri receives 183 votes to be elected to office, while opposition candidate and Mutahida Majlis-e-Amal's Asad Mahmood receives 144 votes. Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf leader Shah Mahmood Qureshi expresses gratitude to all the allies for their support addressing the National Assembly session after Speaker and Deputy Speaker elections. Qureshi says that criticism is opposition's right, adding that the government will welcome different aspects of reform. PPP leader Khurshid Shah, who was the joint opposition's candidate for the speakership, congratulates the newly elected speaker and vows that his party will fully play the role of the opposition but will not create any hurdle in legislation aimed at the welfare of people and national interest.
Aga Siraj Khan Durrani, MPA, has secured 96 votes.
Aga Siraj Durrani, the Pakistan People's Party candidate, re-elected Speaker of the Provincial Assembly of Sindh. Durrani polled 96 votes. His rivals Javed Hanif of Mutahida Qaumi Movement Pakistan receives 59 votes.
के मुताबिक जनाब मुश्ताक अहमद गनी साहब एमपीए स्पीकर के ओहदे के लिए इंतखाब में कामयाब करार पाए।
Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf nominees Mushtaq Ghani and Mahmood Jan elected as the Speaker and Deputy Speaker of the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa Assembly. Newly elected Speaker and Deputy Speaker take oath for the office. Ghani secures 81 votes, while Mahmood Jan secures 78. MPs elect take oath in the inaugural session of the Provincial Assembly of the Punjab. Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz member Uzma Qadri and former Federal Minister Chaudhry Nisar Ali can remain absent. Election for the offices of Speaker and Deputy Speaker will be held on Thursday. Rafiq Rajwana resigns as Punjab governor. He tells reporters he would soon return to his calling as lawyer. Many London residents express deep concerns over the security situation. They express concerns while speaking in the wake of Tuesday's car attack right outside the Houses of Parliament in central London, which injured at least three people and left almost everyone on the edge. Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan signs a decree to raise tariffs on some of the US imports, including cars, alcohol and tobacco. An official report says, according to the report, the decree raises the tariffs on passenger cars by 120%, alcohol by 140% and tobacco by 60%. And more than 30 people have been killed and 10,000 displaced by flood in the Indian state of Kerala. More than 350 buildings have been turned into camps for the displaced people. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. A very warm welcome to 92 News HD. My name is Faik Mahmood. Starting off with the top story today, Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf nominee Asad Kaiser was on Wednesday elected the National Assembly Speaker, securing 176 votes to Pakistan People's Party's Khurshid Shah's 146. After he was administered oath of the office by his predecessors, Ayaz Sadiq, the Speaker said he would devise future house business in consultation with the opposition.
Asad Kesar, the former Khyber Pakhtunkhwa Assembly Speaker, was elected the National Assembly Speaker on Wednesday. Syed Khurshid Shah, the former leader of the opposition, received 146 votes to Kesar's 176. 330 of the members cast vote, out of which 8 were rejected.
Asad Kesar Saab has been declared to have been elected as Speaker of the National Assembly of Pakistan.
Speaker Ayaz Sadiq administered the oath to the speaker-elect. Several Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz MNAs surrounded the speaker's dais and shouted slogans to protest alleged rigging in the general elections. Speaker Kesar then adjourned the session for 15 minutes. Talking to 92 News, Asad Kesar said he thanked Allah Almighty for the high office to which he had been elected.
I chairman Imran Khan ka shukriya ada karta hu ki unhone mujhe is qabil samjha ki mujhe ye zimmedari di aur main apne tamam pakistani bhaiyon ka jinhone PTI ke upar aitmad kiya hai aur PTI ko mandate diya hai.
Asad Kesar said parliamentary reforms would be one of his priorities. He said he would do his best to maintain decorum.
Pakistan People's Party leader Khurshid Shah, who was the joint opposition's candidate for the speakership, congratulated the newly elected speaker and vowed that his party will fully play the role of the opposition but will not create any hurdle in legislation aimed at the welfare of people and national interest. "We will not let Shahid Benazir Bhutto's sacrifices for democracy go to waste," he said, adding, "We will make our best efforts to work for Pakistan, its constitution and its law."
मैं अपनी तरफ से, अपनी पार्टी की तरफ से, सेवान की तरफ से मुबारकबाद देता हूँ और उम्मीद करता हूँ कि इंशाल्लाह ये पार्लियामेंट इस मुल्क की सावरन पार्लियामेंट है और मुझे फख्र है कि मेरी पार्टी ने, मेरे कायदीन ने इस पार्लियामेंट को कायम रखने के लिए अपनी जिंदगियां दे दी हैं और इंशाल्लाह आने वाले वक्त में भी पाकिस्तान पीपल्स पार्टी की और अपोजिशन की ये पूरी कोशिश होगी कि हम इस पार्लियामेंट के तकद्दस को बहाल रखें, इसके वकार को बहाल रखें.
Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf leader Shah Mahmood Qureshi on Wednesday has expressed gratitude to the all allies of their support. Addressing the National Assembly session after Speaker and Deputy Speaker elections, Qureshi said that criticism is opposition's right. "We'll welcome different aspects of reforms," he added.
"Hum yahan apni parliamentary meeting mein 176 voton ka hisab laga kar aaye the aur alhamdulillah अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह जब गिनती हुई तो 176 के 176 वोट यहां निकले. आपकी तनकीद से कोई इस्लाह का पहलू अगर उजागर होता है तो हम उस इस्लाह के पहलू को फराखदिली से कबूल करेंगे."
360 MPAs elect took oath in the inaugural session of the Provincial Assembly of the Punjab today. Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz member Uzma Qadri and former Federal Minister Chaudhry Nisar Ali Khan were absent. Election for the offices of Speaker and Deputy Speaker will be held on Thursday.
...360 MPAs of the 17th Punjab Assembly have taken oaths. Speaker Rana Muhammad Iqbal Khan administered the oaths. 11 members elected, including former Interior Minister Chaudhry Nisar Ali Khan and Uzma Qadri, did not take oaths. Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf has nominated Chaudhry Parvez Ilahi of the Pakistan Muslim League Qaid for Speaker. Chaudhry Iqbal Gujar is the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz candidate for the office. The PTI has nominated Dost Muhammad Mazari and PML and Waris Kalu for Deputy. Deputy Speaker. Elahi said on Wednesday, if elected, he would treat all MPAs the same. Maulana Ghiyasuddin, elected for the fourth time from Narwal, arrived in an auto rickshaw. In 2013, he had arrived on a motorcycle. PMLN member Tariq Gill wore a chain in a symbolic protest.
Agha Siraj Durrani, the Pakistan People's Party's candidate, was re-elected Speaker of the Provincial Assembly of Sindh on Wednesday. Durrani polled 96 votes. His rival Javed Hanif of Mutahida Qaumi Movement Pakistan received 59 votes.
Now I request the newly elected Speaker to come over and take oath, please.
The Pakistan People's Party had nominated Durrani for Speaker and Rehana Lighari for Deputy Speaker. The opposition coalition had fielded Javed Hanif of MKM Pakistan for Speaker and Rabia Asfar Nizami of the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf for Deputy Speaker. Following his election, Durrani was administered the oath by Presiding Officer Nader Maksi.
Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf nominees Mushtaq Ghani and Mahmood Jan were elected Speaker and Deputy Speaker of the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa Assembly on Wednesday. Ghani secured 81 votes and Mahmood Jan 78.
DJ ke mutabik janab Mushtaq Ahmed Ghani sahab MPA Speaker ke ohde ke liye intikhab mein kamyab raha hai.
Sardar Aurangzeb Nalota chaired the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa Assembly session to hold the election for Speaker. PTI candidate Mushtaq Ghani, a former provincial minister, was facing Awami National Parties like Muhammad Khan for Speaker. Hidayatur Rahman, representative from PK1 Chitral, was the first of 108 members to cast ballot. Ghani secured 81 votes and like Muhammad bagged 27. Nalota then administered to the new Speaker. Mahmood Jan was elected Deputy Speaker by securing 78 votes. His rival Jamshed Muhammad from Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz bagged 30 votes. Speaker Mushtaq Ghani then administered the oath to the Mahmood Jan.
The Supreme Court on Wednesday sought an implementation report on the cabinet decision in Asghar Khan case in a month. A three-member bench headed by Chief Justice Mia Saqib Nisar is hearing the case.
The cabinet has decided that the army officers be tried in military courts. Why has the order not been implemented? The Chief Justice asked. A representative of the Ministry of Defense said it had not received a summary in this regard for the Interior Ministry. He requested the court to grant 4 weeks' time for the submission of a detailed report in this regard. The court granted a request. The CJP said if the order was not implemented, the court would next summon the military authority rather than a ministry official. No one is above the law. The order of the court should be implemented, the Chief Justice remarked. The FIA Director General told the court that in a telephone conversation, Mir Zafarullah Jamali, the former Prime Minister, had denied receiving the money. He said Mir Hasil Bazinjo and Humayun Murray had been busy in election campaign. They will appear before the court, he said. The court directed the Defense Ministry to provide the relevant information to the FIA and adjourn the hearing until September 15.
An accountability court on Wednesday adjourned the hearing of two National Accountability Bureau references against former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif till August 20th. Earlier, the court recorded prosecution evidence in Al Azizia Steel Mills reference.
The court recorded the statement of NAB investigation officer Mehboob Alam in the Al Azizia reference. Nawaz Sharif was produced in the court presided over by Judge Arshad Malik. Investigating Officer Mehboob Alam gave evidence. The court directed the witness to continue at the next hearing on August 20. The court also summoned Panama Leaks Joint Investigation Team ahead Wajid Zia for the hearing on Monday.
Rafiq Rajwana resigned as Punjab governor on Wednesday. He told reporters he would soon return to his calling as lawyer. We'll be right back.
Rajwana said following the general elections, a new government was about to take over. He said the governor would appoint a new governor. He said he had consulted the PMLN leadership in this regard. Rajwana was appointed the 36th governor of Punjab in 2015, replacing Chaudhary Sarwar. Sarwar has recently been named as Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf's choice for the office.
More news stories lined up right after a short break. Keep watching 92 News. Welcome back after the break. Many London residents expressed deep concern on Wednesday over the security situation. They were speaking in the wake of Tuesday's car attack right outside the Houses of Parliament in central London, which injured at least three people and left almost everyone on the edge.
A 29-year-old British male was later arrested on suspicion of carrying out terror attack, according to the local police. The police are treating it as a deliberate act and a terrorist attack.
No, at first that they injured some people. I just thought it was a man that had a crash. But then when they said that people had been injured, it just makes you wonder, you know, where you're safe, really, you know. So. It's so awful.
With its history of similar incident, people in the UK are concerned about their own safety and are calling out to the authorities for taking necessary measures to put an end to these acts. I didn't know at the first it injured some people. I just thought it was a man that had a crash. But when it said that people had been injured, just made you wonder where you are safe, said Sherry Green, a London resident.
Because they could have taken it before. I mean, it's been happening for a while now that all these things have been happening. So why haven't they taken measurements? It's like, what else needs to happen for them to do it?
It's been happening for a while now, so why haven't they taken the measures? What else needs to be happened for them to do it? Said another Londoner named Wendy. On March 22 last year, as near the House of Parliament had left, five people dead and 50 injured.
Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf chairman Imran Khan was allowed on Wednesday to cast his vote in the election for NS Speaker and Deputy Speaker without producing his National Assembly card. Alleging discriminatory behavior, Patel said he had been stopped for not producing the card. Speaker Sardar Ayaz Sadiq replied that Imran Khan asked him for permission, which was granted. Had you asked for it, I would have granted you permission as well, he told the objector. Hamza Shahbaz, the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz candidate for leader of the House in the Provincial Assembly to Punjab, said on Wednesday the party will perform its constitutional role in the legislature. Talking to the media, he said the PMLN will lead a strong opposition. He also criticized Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf leader Jahangir Tareen. Here is what else he said.
Inshallah ta'ala, kariya kariya, gaon gaon, awaaz uthayenge. ایوان کے اندر بھی آواز اٹھائیں گے ایوان کے باہر بھی آواز اٹھائیں گے اور پاکستان کے اعلیٰ مفاد میں آج ہم حلف لے کر اپنی آئینی ذمہ داریوں کو پورا کریں گے ایک نااہل شخص جس کو عدالت عظمیٰ نے نااہل کیا ہے وہ جہازوں میں ممبرز کو بٹھا کر گھومتا پھرتا تھا اور پھر وہی سیاست پیسے کی شروع کر دی ان شاء اللہ تعالیٰ ان تمام چیزوں کو عوام بخوبی جانتے ہیں ہم بھی بے نقاب کریں گے اور ان شاء اللہ تعالیٰ پاکستان کو مضبوط تر ملک بنائیں گے
عوامی مسلم لیگ چیف شیخ رشید سیڈ آن وینسڈے پاکستان مسلم لیگ نواز ایم این ایز ور ریزنگ ہیو اینڈ کرائی ایون بیفور عمران خانز اوتھ ایز کنٹریز پرائم منسٹر
ابھی تو اس نے حلف نہیں اٹھایا چیخیں مارنے لگے ہیں ایسا احتساب کا قانون بنائیں گے کہ لاہور لکشمی تک چیخوں کی آوازیں جائیں گی الیکشن کا سسٹم فلاپ ہوا خراب ہوا لاس کوئسچن کوئی ملک کا ایسا حلقہ بتائیں جہاں ورچیاں کم نکلی ہوں ڈبے سے زیادہ نکلی ہوں پھر تو میں سمجھتا ہوں وہاں دھاندلی ہوئی ہے وہاں ری الیکشن ہونا چاہیے اگر پرچیاں اتنی ہیں جتنی ڈبے میں سے نکلی ہیں ایک شناختی کارڈ دو بندے چیک کرتے ہیں جی اتنا لمبا پروسیس ہے ہمارے ہاں چھ کینڈیڈیٹ تھے چھ بندہ دیکھتے ہیں یہ وہی ہے چھ آدمیوں کے آگے سے شناختی کارڈ گزرتا ہے اگر پھر بھی کوئی جعلی ووٹ پول ہو جاتی ہے تو لعنت ہے جو لوگ وہاں بیٹھے ہیں
A total strike was observed in the Indian-occupied Kashmir on Wednesday as Kashmiris marked India's Independence Day as a day of protest.
Kashmiris everywhere in the world are recording their protests against Indian occupation by marking India's Independence Day as a Black Day. Reports from the occupied valley said the entire state appeared to be in mourning. The media said Indian occupation forces have turned the entire valley into a cantonment. They said Bakshi Stadium in Srinagar had been transformed into a fortress after Hurriyat leaders called for a protest march towards the city landmark. Most senior leaders of the All Parties Hurriyat Conference have already been put under house arrest.
As in other parts of the world, Pakistanis living in Canada also celebrated the 71st Independence Day on Tuesday. Ceremonies were held in several cities, all Pakistani consulates of the country. For more on this, have a look at this report made by our correspondent Nadeem Tufail.
Pakistan Cultural Association organized a flag hoisting ceremony at City Center building in Calgary, which has attended by besides members of Pakistani community, political and social figure. National flag was hoisted at the building as national anthem was played in the background. Following the event, Pakistan Festival was held at Olympic Plaza. On the occasion, a musical band and local singer Suhail Raja sang national songs. In the evening, a function was held under the auspices of Pakistani Canada Association at a local call. People belonging to different walks of life attended the event. Participants danced to the drum beat lit up the occasion. Members of local assemblies in their speeches felicitated the Pakistanis on their Independence Day.
ਅਸੀਂ ਅੱਜ ਇੱਥੇ ਕੈਲਗਰੀ ਸਿਟੀ ਹਾਲ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਇੰਡੀਪੈਂਡੈਂਸ ਡੇ ਮਨਾਉਣ ਲਈ ਇੱਥੇ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਹੋਏ ਆ ਤੇ ਫਲੈਗ ਸੈਰੇਮਨੀ ਹੋਈ ਆ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਭਰਿਆ ਮਾਹੌਲ ਹੈਗਾ ਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਤੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਪਰਿਵਾਰ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਕੈਲਗਰੀ ਦੀ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਕੈਲਗਰੀ ਦੀ ਅਲਬਰਟਾ ਦੀ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਸਾਰੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਦੀ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨੀ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਨੂੰ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਆਜ਼ਾਦੀ ਦਿਵਸ ਦੀਆਂ ਹੈਗੀਆਂ ਮੁਬਾਰਕਾਂ ਦਿੰਦਾ ਹੈਗਾ
ਮੈਂ ਤਮਾਮ ਫੈਲੋ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨੀ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨੀਜ਼ ਕੋ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ ਦਾ ਗਲੋਬ ਹੈਪੀ ਇੰਡੀਪੈਂਡੈਂਸ ਡੇ ਆਜ਼ਾਦ ਜਸ਼ਨ ਆਜ਼ਾਦੀ ਮੁਬਾਰਕ ਕਰਤਾ ਹੂੰ
ਇੱਕ ਯਹੀ ਪਹਿਚਾਨ ਸੀ ਮੇਰੀ ਇਸ ਪਹਿਚਾਨ ਸੇ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਕਾ ਸ਼ਹਿਰੀ ਥਾ ਮੈਂ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਸੇ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਮੇਰੀ ਤਰਫ ਸੇ ਆਪ ਤਮਾਮ ਸਾਮਾਇਨ ਔਰ ਨਾਜ਼ਰੀਨ 92 ਨਿਊਜ਼ ਚੈਨਲ ਕੋ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਯੋਮ ਆਜ਼ਾਦੀ ਮੁਬਾਰਕ
ਦੁਨੀਆ ਭਰ ਮੈਂ ਬਸਨੇ ਵਾਲੇ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨੀ ਉਸਕਾ ਨਾਮ ਰੋਸ਼ਨ ਕਰੇ ਔਰ ਆਪਣੇ ਬਹਿਨ ਭਾਈਓ ਕਾ ਖਿਆਲ ਰੱਖੇ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਾਬਾਦ
ਚਿਲਡਰਨ ਔਨ ਦੀ ਓਕੇਜ਼ਨ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੈਂਟਡ ਟੈਬਲੋਸ ਐਂਡ ਲੋਕਲ ਡਾਂਸਸ ਇਨ ਦੀ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਪਾਰਟਿਸਪੈਂਟਸ ਵਰ ਸਰਵ ਅ ਡਿਨਰ ਅ ਫੀਮੇਲ ਸਿੰਗਰ ਫਰਮ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਐਂਟਰਟੇਨ ਦੀ ਆਡੀਅੰਸ
ਐਵਰੀ ਈਅਰ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨੀ ਕੈਨੇਡੀਅਨ ਸੈਲੀਬ੍ਰੇਟ ਦੇਅਰ ਨੇਸ਼ਨ ਬਰਥ ਐਨਵਰਸਰੀ ਇਨ ਆਗਸਟ ਟੂ ਸ਼ੋ ਯੂਨਿਟੀ ਐਂਡ ਲਵ ਫਾਰ ਦ ਮਦਰਲੈਂਡ ਕੈਮਰਾ ਪਰਸਨ ਚੌਧਰੀ ਤਹਾਰ ਨਦੀਮ ਤੁਫੈਲ 92 ਨਿਊਜ਼ ਕੈਲਗਰੀ ਕੈਨੇਡਾ
More news stories lined up right after a short break. Keep watching 92 News. Rescuers scored the wreckage of Italy's bridge collapse on Wednesday as the death toll climbed to 37 and the government blamed the bridge's private owner, demanding resignations and moving to strip its toll concessions. More in this report.
As cranes move into the shift truck-sized chunk of broken concrete, hundreds of firefighters search for survivors, while public shock and grief turned into anger over the state of the 1.2-kilometer-long bridge completed in 1967 and overhauled 2 years ago. The 50-year-old bridge, part of a tall motorway linking the port city of Genoa with southern France, collapsed during torrential rain on Tuesday, sending dozens of vehicles crashing onto a riverbed, a railway and two warehouses. Fire Brigade spokesman Luca Curry said 400 firefighters were at the site, lifting big chunks of concrete to create space for rescue teams to check for survivors. The condition of the bridge and its ability to sustain large increase in both of the intensity and weight of traffic over the years have been a focus of public debate since Tuesday's collapse. 180-meter span gave way at lunchtime as car packed with holidaymakers as well as trucks stream across it.
Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan signed a decree to raise tariffs on some of the U.S. imports, including cards, alcohol and tobacco, an official report said on Wednesday.
According to the report, the decree raised the tariff on passenger cars by 120%, alcohol by 140% and tobacco by 60%. Tariffs on cosmetics, rice and coal were also increased. On Friday, Trump administration doubled tariff on steel and aluminium imports from Turkey. President Erdogan said it was against the rule of the World Trade Organization and called it an economic war. The news pushed the Turkish lira to its record low the same day. In addition, the president also called on a boycott of U.S. electronics.
Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan's spokesman Ebrahim Kalan said on Wednesday that Turkey will continue talks with the United States if it shows constructive stance for the solution of a diplomatic rift. For more on this, have a look at this report.
Speaking at weekly briefing, Kalin also said that he expected problems with the United States, which helped drive the lira to record lows, to be resolved, but Washington must stop trying to influence Turkey's judiciary. Ankara and Washington, NATO allies, have been at loggerheads over the detention in Turkey of U.S. Evangelical pastor Andrew Brunson on terrorism charges prompting U.S. sanctions on two of Erdogan's ministers and higher tariff on metal export. Turkey retaliated by doubling tariff on some U.S. imports, including alcohol, cars and tobacco. Turkish lira has lost more than 40% against the dollar this year, driven by worries over Erdogan's growing influence over the economy and his repeated calls for lower interest rate despite high inflation. Kalin said, Turkey will keep working to escape from U.S. dollar pressure by taking a positive stance to trade in national currencies. He also stressed Ankara would exercise its right if the U.S. does not deliver F-35 jets to Ankara. U.S. President Donald Trump signed a $716 billion defense policy bill on Monday that directs the Secretary of Defense to study whether Turkey's planned deployment of the Russian-made S-400 missile defense system will risk the security of several U.S.-made weapons used by Turkey, including the F-35 jet. The mandate to produce a study came after an earlier version proposed to bar the delivery of F-35s to Turkey.
U.S. President Donald Trump on Wednesday compared terrorists with animals and stressed the need for taking stringent steps against terrorism. Condemning the latest terrorist attack near the Parliament House in London on Twitter, Trump said the terrorists were animals gone mad. He stressed the need for dealing with terrorists with an iron hand. New Zealand school teachers went on strike on Wednesday for the first time in more than 20 years, challenging the Labour government's plans to balance promised fiscal responsibility against growing demands to increase public sector salaries.
Almost 30,000 primary school teachers did not turn up for work and held protests across the country, leaving parents of roughly 400,000 children aged 5 to 13 at public schools scrambling to find childcare.
So I'm here today to ask you to work with us as we try and move forward.
The standoff with its traditional union support base comes 9 months after Labour formed a coalition government, promising to pour money into social services and rein in inequality, which has increased despite years of strong growth.
Rather be teaching right now than marching, but no one's listening to us.
New Zealand's Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern made a surprise appearance outside Parliament on Wednesday with a group of ministers to welcome the more than 1,000 protesting teachers. "I am here today to ask you to work with us and we try to move forward," she told the crowd.
"An outcome that delivers quality education to all children."
NZEI, the union that represents teachers, said it had asked for a 16% pay rise for teachers over 2 years, whereas the government has offered between 6.1 and 14.7%, depending on experience over 3 years.
More than 30 people have been killed and tens of thousands displaced by floods in the Indian state of Kerala. More than 350 buildings have been turned into camps for the displaced people.
It has been 5 days since 51-year-old Katyani came to one of the camps. She and her 29-year-old son fled after three quarters of their small home was submerged in rainwater.
വെള്ളം കയറിയപ്പോൾ ഞങ്ങൾ കൈ കെട്ടിയത് ഡ്രസ്സ് തുണിയൊക്കെ ആയിട്ട് വേഗം കയറി മുകളിലേക്ക് റോഡിലേക്ക് കയറി വന്ന് അതൊക്കെ എടുക്കാൻ ഞങ്ങളെക്കൂടെ സഹായിച്ചോളും വെള്ളം പെട്ടെന്ന് നല്ല സ്പീഡിലായിരുന്നു വെള്ളം കയറി വന്നത്.
Katyani is one of the nearly 100 people housed at the camp until the water recedes. 27 families have taken shelter at this camp. All of them have lost their homes to the floods. When water came in, we ran away with whatever we could grab. The water came very fast. We had to save our lives. We lost so many things. Many of our belongings were left behind. Many of our belongings were left behind. We don't know what's happened to them, said Katyani.
ഞങ്ങളുടെ വീട് ചില വീടുകൾ പൂർണ്ണമായിട്ടും ഭാഗികമായിട്ടൊക്കെ നശിച്ചു പോയിട്ടുണ്ട് ഒരു താമസ സൗകര്യം ഇപ്പോൾ പെട്ടെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് നടക്കില്ല
But not all. We are so lucky. Over 30 people have lost their lives in the state's worst flooding since 1924. The floods have left more than 54,000 people displaced and damaged around 20,000 houses. Kerala has seen violent and torrential rains that have led to landslides and it has suffered $1.2 billion worth of losses.
More news stories lined up right after a short break. Keep watching 92 News. Serena Williams was beaten 6-3, 2-6, 6-3 by Petra Kvitova in the thrilling second round match at the Cincinnati Open on Tuesday, ending the Americans' bid for a third title at the event.
Williams looked rusty in the first set, struggling to handle the Czech's booming left-handed serve and nerve created a breakpoint opportunity.
Game Kvitova.
But the 23 Grand Slam champion dug deep in the second, thumping serves and blasting returns to the delight of the supportive crowd under the lights. Williams appeared to be in the command when she broke Kvitova to start the deciding third set, but the two-time Wimbledon champion elevated her service game and was defensively resolute to set up a third-round clash with Kristina of France. For former world number one Williams, the loss is another setback as she attempts to get back to the top ranking after a difficult childbirth last year.
Swimmer Ross Edgley broke the world record for the longest stayed sea swim on Tuesday when he completed 74 days in the sea as he attempts to swim around Britain.
The record, which needs to be verified by the Open Water Swimming Authorities, betters the 73 days that Frenchman Benoit sat when swimming across the Atlantic in 1998.
Really, the pain is the best case scenario. Worst case scenario are itching as the toxins basically go around your body. They start attacking your nervous system. If it got you in the mouth, your airways can actually sort of start to close up, which makes breathing a little bit difficult. And also as well, just kind of muscles going into spasm.
The British 32-year-old set off from Margate in Kent on June 1 and still has 900 miles to go to complete the 2,000 miles journey around the coast.
And the whole Great British Swim, it just feels like just getting slammed by wind and waves, and we were just seeking refuge out in the harbour. And then we've kind of come out today, thought, right, we need to get to Mullicantyre, we need to get to halfway. And in a weird way, clouds are cleared, sunshine's come out. It's like somebody's going, there you go, well done, guys. Well done.
You!
Mullicantyre.
Edgley, who swims for 6 hours at a time with 6 hour rest, said that swimming at night and jellyfish were the worst obstacle he has had to overcome.
Two-time champion Fernando Alonso announced on Tuesday that he will retire from Formula One at the end of the year 2018 season, 17 years after he made his debut in the sport.
The Spaniard, who hails from Oviedo, won back-to-back driver's title in 2005 and 2006 with Renault before leaving for McLaren in 2007. But Alonso endured a turbulent years with the manufacturer and left after just one season to rejoin Renault in 2008. 2 years later, Alonso left to link up with Ferrari, where he stayed for 5 years before a return to McLaren in 2015. His retirement will bring an end to a difficult four-head period during which Alonso has failed to win a race. The 37-year-old, who has chalked up 97 podiums, has not won since the 2013 Spanish Grand Prix, the last of 32 career victories in F1. Alonso is ninth in the season's driver's standing on 44 points despite driving an uncompetitive car. He's 36 points ahead of teammate Stoffel Vandoorne.
Crazy Rich Asians cast talk box office race. Personal identity as much as representation is at the heart of Crazy Rich Asians, which hits the theaters on Friday.
Based on the widely popular titular novel, it centers on New York City Chinese-American economic professor Rachel Chu, who accompanies her boyfriend to Singapore for his best friend's wedding, only to become thrust into the lives of Asia's rich and famous. She discovers that her boyfriend comes from a very wealthy family with a dark past, and that every woman wants him.
I think the best thing is it's unapologetically Asian. It just so happens to be an Asian story, but the fact that the story shines through the most and is relatable to everybody, not just Asians, is my big takeaway for that.
The film's casting has been met with both praise for its all-Asian cast as well as criticism for its casting non-Chinese actors playing Chinese roles. However, it is still being considered a step forward for Hollywood, which is often accused of whitewashing Asian characters.
We've made the movie. We are promoting as hard as we can. You can see the bags under our eyes. But the audience needs to decide. If they show up on that opening weekend and they show they're buying tickets, that sends a very clear message to the studios that more will be made. They're sitting on their desks right now with movies that have not been greenlit, that are ready to. They're watching to see how this weekend goes. And if it works, then we get another shot and we don't have to depend on one story with one set of characters. Suddenly we can broaden out to a lot more things.
Crazy Rich Asians hit theaters on Friday.
The Material Girl turns 60 on August 16. American singer, author, and businesswoman Madonna was born in 1958 in Michigan, United States.
The multi-Grammy Award winner and Rebel Heart singer, who was presented with Billboard magazine's Women of the Year Award in 2016, told Reuters back then that one of her biggest challenges was being a good mother. The pop diva reinvented herself in 2003, donning the mantle of children's author and launching her book, The English Roses, in 100 languages, in 100 countries, and 30 languages in an unprecedented publishing blitz.
The initial inspiration was I was going to make a two-sided album and have like 10 songs in each side. One side was, that's why I called it Rebel Heart. One side was going to represent the more rebellious, provocative, envelope-pushing part side of me. And then the other side was going to be the more romantic, vulnerable side of me.
In the July this year, Madonna launched a 60,000 fundraiser through her Facebook page to mark her 60th birthday. It supports her work with Malawi youngsters, raising more than $10,000 in the first 24 hours for her Raising Malawi Foundation's rural orphanage, Homes of Hope.
It doesn't get harder to write music, to write songs. I think it gets harder to find producers who have long periods of time to sit in the studio with you to finish the production, especially when you're working with DJs who are really busy traveling around. And also then there's the music not leaking component. That makes things harder.
A mother of six children, Madonna adopted four-year-old twin Malawi girls, Esther and Stella, in 2017 and opened a children's hospital in the country's second biggest city, Blantyre. Her family also includes Malawi children David Banda and Mercy James, and biological children Lords Leon and Rocco Ritchie from her previous relationship.
A trailer has been released for Hollywood action movie Avengers 4. The movie tells the story of a character who considers humans his enemies and makes attempts to eliminate them. The movie will hit the cinemas on May 3rd.
The world's on fire. You think all's forgiven?
I'm not looking for forgiveness, and I'm way past asking permission.
The universe lies within your grasp.
He invades planets, he wipes out half the population.
They called me a madman.
That's all from the news studios. For more details, you can visit our website 92newsHD.tv and keep watching 92 News.